Good evening. Welcome. Hard to believe it's already June, and we're here at our spring concert, but we have a wonderful concert prepared for you tonight. We're very excited to play. We've got a wide range of music to show you tonight, and it's been an exciting 10 months for the Instrumental Music Program. All of our ensembles have done and developed amazingly this year. We're very proud of all of them. As you can see, we've asked all the students to be here at the start of the concert, and we've also asked them to stay for the remainder of the concert to support all of the students and all of the efforts they've made in their performance tonight. Thank you. Enjoy the show.
The Barber of Seville is an opera buffa, or an Italian comic opera, by Giacchino Rossini. A famous example of Rossini's characteristic Italian style, it has proven to be one of the greatest masterpieces of comedy within music. Even after 200 years, it remains a popular work. It premiered on February 20th, 1816, at the Teatro Argentina in Rome. It would become the first Italian opera ever performed in America, premiering at the Park Theater in New York on November 29, 1825.
Thank you. The Sorcerer's Apprentice is a symphonic poem by the French composer Paul Dugas, completed in 1897. The piece was based on a 1797 poem of the same name. By far the most popular and recorded of Dugas' works, its notable appearance in the Walt Disney 1940 animated film Fantasia has led to the piece becoming widely known to audiences outside the classical concert hall.
Jim Casella has written music for concert, film, commercials, and drum corps. Technology is his first composition for percussion ensemble and was composed in 1998. It features solos for mallets, timpani, snare drum, and toms. Jim Casella is best known for his percussion ensemble pieces and for the drum corps music he has written for Vanguard and the Cavaliers. He co-founded the company Tapspace, which is one of the leading publishers of percussion music in the world. He lives in Portland, Oregon. Thanks to Sam Davis for joining our group to perform this composition.
As the title implies, Engines of Resistance is a piece based on two opposing themes that are resisting each other. One theme is aggressive and angular, while the other theme is lyrical and flowing. There is a constant motor element representing the engine, and the strings, winds, and percussion fighting against the lyrical melodic material.
Pinball Wizard was first performed by the English rock band The Who, as featured on their 1969 epic rock opera album, Tommy. The original recording was released as a single in 1969 and reached number 4 in the UK charts and number 19 on the US Billboard Top 100. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Minnie the Moocher is a jazz song first recorded in 1931 by Cab Calloway and his orchestra, selling over 1 million copies. The song is most famous for its nonsensical ad-libbed scat lyrics. For example, Heidi, 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 Ho. In performances, Calloway would have the audience participate by repeating each scat phrase in a form of call and response. Tonight, we invite you to participate and sing in response to our orchestra scat singing.
Children of Sanchez by Chuck Mangione, arranged by Bob Phillips and Jerry Dennison. In the 1970s, Chuck Mangione became an international music star writing jazz pop music and playing his flugelhorn. His first smash hit was Feel So Good, which he debuted in 1977. The following year, he wrote and performed the title soundtrack to the movie Children of Sanchez. This title song was another hit which won the Grammy for Best Pop Instrumental Performance.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. And as of right now, we're going to take a little momentary pause so we can bring this group down and bring the next group up. So Wind Symphony and Advanced Strings, you can start the move. And we will get started in probably about between 5 and 10 minutes. There are refreshments available for sale out in the lobby. Thank you so much.
Igor Stravinsky is a Russian-born composer and conductor who is regarded as one of the most important and influential composers of the 20th century. The Firebird is a ballet and orchestral concert work which was written for the Paris Opera season in 1910. The ballet is based on the Russian fairy tales of the Firebird, a magical glowing bird from a faraway land, which is both a blessing and a bringer of doom to its captor. This ballet was a breakthrough piece for Stravinsky, which led to his other acclaimed works, including Petrushka in 1911 and The Rite of Spring in 1913.
Thank you.
I've Got You Under My Skin is a song written by Cole Porter in 1936. It was introduced that year by Eleanor Powell in the musical film Born to Dance, in which it was performed by Virginia Bruce. It was nominated for Academy Award for Best Original Song that year. And it became a signature song for Frank Sinatra, and in 1966 became a top 10 hit for Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons.
Thank you.
Stormbreak was composed in 2009 and is scored for percussion ensemble and optional wind ensemble. Tonight's performance does not include wind ensemble. The composition begins with some atmospheric sounds produced by a timpani drum with an upside-down cymbal, plus an ocean drum and rain stick. This piece also features solos played by snare drum, toms, timpani, and mallets. In addition to composing music for concert occasions, Jim Casella has composed music for film. His film scores include music for the following films: Rock and Roll Eddie, Filling In, Roller Coaster, and Plague. Thanks to Zach Pacino and Abigail Edwards for joining our group on mallet percussion. Triumph of the Argonauts by Robert Sheldon. The Argonauts were a band of heroes in Greek mythology who accompanied Jason in his quest to find the Golden Fleece. Their name comes from their ship, the Argo, which was named after its builder, Argus. This composition was inspired by the heroic journey and its crew as they overcame the numerous challenges presented by the gods to capture the Golden Fleece and return home, where Jason would assume his rightful role as king.
Thank you. At this very moment, composer John Williams is working on the score for his final Star Wars film, Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker. Once this movie is released, the orchestral score will be added to the other 8 films also scored by Williams. Many are considering these 9 scores to be Williams' 9 symphonies. The score from The Empire Strikes Back was recorded in 18 sessions at Anvil Studios over 3 days in December 1979 and a further 6 days in January 1980, with Williams conducting the London Symphony Orchestra. The score won another Academy Award nomination for Williams. The finale of this soundtrack features several of Williams' iconic themes from the saga, including the Force theme, Han Solo and the Princess, the main theme, Yoda's theme, and the Imperial March. Most of these themes were revisited by Williams for the soundtrack to the most recent Star Wars films, The Force Awakens and The Last Jedi.
Thank you. With some brilliant new themes, along with some familiar strains from the first two films, Hans Zimmer's powerful musical backdrop sets the adventure level at an all-time high for the characters of Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End, a fun and mischievous film. This arrangement includes Hoist the Colors, Singapore, I See Dead People in Boats, Up is Down, and Drink Up, Me Hearties.
Thank you.
making its 12th annual appearance in Mr. Regalio's arrangement of Illuminations. The music accompanies the fireworks at Epcot each evening. The piece is actually divided into three movements. Chaos, representing the creation of the planet Earth from a cosmic event. Order, as the Earth cools, it changes from hot white to red to blue. Chaos turns to order. And meaning, where the theme We Go On is heard in different styles, followed by an upbeat conclusion in mixed meter. The piece also includes a short coda placed at the end. This tag ending entitled We Go On will feature orchestra members as vocalists, as well as backup vocals performed by most of the orchestra. We also begin the piece with a short poem composed by orchestra alumnus Juliana Di Clemente and inspired by the opening narrative before the fireworks begin. We hope you enjoy this evening's concert, and now we present Illuminations, Reflections of Earth.
It tells us a story, our own story, as old as time itself, still being written, from the chaos of the formation and sudden changes in the world, to the gradual settling of the excited elements, as everything slowly cools from those precipitous changes, then to the celebration of formation of life on the newly forged and still evolving planet. We gather around the crackling fire to hear this ancient story passed down from one to another. The story of our home, the Earth.
stillness of the night, there comes a time to understand, to reach out and touch tomorrow, take the future in our hands. We can see a new horizon built on all that we have done, and our dreams begin another 1,000
Well, I told you at the beginning, you're in for a treat. It's been an awesome year. And I just want to say a special shout out to our seniors this year. Thank you for your dedication and your inspiration. You've been an awesome class, and you'll be missed. And thank you, and have a great night.